Welcome to Living Hills Senior Living Earth. My name is Ashley, one of the educators here at the Living Hills Discovery Center. Now, here on YouTube every day, Monday to Friday at 11 a.m., we are premiering different videos where you can get a chance to learn about nature and all the wonderful things of it. Now, we do our best to bring all kinds of different videos to you to learn about all the different wonderful animals that are here at the Living Hills, so hopefully inspiring you to care for nature. Now, during this time, the Living Hills Discovery Center is closed, but we are still caring for all of our animals here as a small nonprofit zoo and aquarium located in Chula Vista. We are doing our best to make sure we are bringing all of our natural animals into your homes so you can learn all about them as well. Now, today, we are going to be playing a game of trivia. So I have some questions that I'm going to ask, and you can go ahead and answer them and test your knowledge to see how much knowledge you know about these random trivia facts. And today's theme is actually all about fish. So today we're actually at our Bay Community Exhibit, which is full of all kinds of different native species of fish and even some sharks. So we have our Kirabali, the California state fish. We have calico bass, who's swimming around in here. And down at the bottom, maybe if they wake up and they start swimming around a little bit, you'll be able to see, we even have some sharks in here. We have horned sharks, as well as an eel. So a nice variety of different native species that call San Diego home. All right, are you ready to get started? So today our first question is going to be, true or false? Fish show the greatest amount of species diversity than any other group of vertebrates. True or false? Is actually going to be true. Fish do show the greatest amount of species diversity than any other group of vertebrates. So they're not the most diverse group of all animals, but they are the most diverse of all vertebrates. Animals with backbones, they are going to have the most diversity, as there are actually over 30,000 different species of fish. So they're very diverse. Fish range in size, color, habitat type, and feeding habits. Even in here, we have lots of different colors, from berries to bright orange, and you probably won't be able to see it, but even down at the bottom in our rocky substrate, we have a flounder hiding down there. So, all kinds of different sizes and colors just right here. Fish can be found all over the world in a variety of different habitats, from small creeks to ponds to even large ocean habitats. And this is what allows for that great species diversity. Having the ability to live in all of those different areas causes species diversity to occur from those different types of fish. Question number two. What is the fastest swimming fish? What fish has been recorded as the fastest swimming fish? You can be specific on the individual fish or just the grouping of that type of fish. Now, it is very difficult to measure accurately the speed of how fast an animal is swimming or running. Swimming especially can be very difficult with these large fish. Scientists do have a lot of trouble trying to record those as fast as possible, but what we do know is that the sailfish is considered by many experts to be the fastest recorded fish on record in the world. This fish has been recorded at speeds of up to 70 miles an hour. Most fish can only go to about 20 kilometers an hour, which is about 12 miles an hour. Sailfish are a type of billfish, which also includes marlins, swordfish, and round-scale spearfish. These types of fish are going to be pelagic and generally from in warmer areas, and they can feed on all kinds of different things, from smaller fish to crustaceans, cephalopods like squid and octopus. But they are commonly considered those fast fish, and marlins are also in this grouping. They're related to them, and marlins are one of those top contenders as well. Made popular by finding Finding Nemo can you find here at the Living Coast Discovery Center? What fish are popularized in the movie Finding Nemo can you find here at Living Coast? Here at Living Coast, we actually are home to two different fish that are really popular within this boat. We have clownfish, which is Nemo, and we have royal blue tanks, or regal tanks, which is what Dory is. Both of these fish are not going to be native species. They're one of our few non-native species that we highlight here at the Living Coast, and they are actually going to be considered tropical fish. These fish are found in warmer waters where there are coral reefs, which are not going to be native here to our waterways, as our waters are very cold. Now, these two species of fish are very important for those coral reef habitats, and unfortunately, due to the popularization of this film, royal blue tangs and clownfish are actually suffering out there in the wild. Because a lot of people are loving them in their at-home aquariums, they're not paying attention to where these fish are being taken from. So if you would like to have a clownfish or a regal tang in your at-home aquarium, that's totally fine. But you do want to make sure you do some research to find out where that fish is from. If it is wild caught from the ocean, you want to make sure to stay away from that. But if it has been born in a zoological facility or in a breeding program, that is a great way for you to incorporate that fish into your at-home exhibit. Alright, our next question is going to be, what is the most poisonous fish? What is the most poisonous fish out there? Now remember, poison and venom are not the same thing. Poison means you eat it, it is ingested. Well, venom is injected. Something usually bites you. Now the most poisonous fish to eat is going to be the puffer fish, whose bodies are actually full of a toxin known as tetrodotoxin. And this toxin is very strong, that you need less than 0.01 grams, less than 0.1 grams to be able to have this become fatal. So you want to make sure that you are staying away from this puffer fish. But it is actually a way that you can eat it. If it's prepared properly, you can ingest puffer fish, which is actually commonly done in Japan. But the chefs that do this, they do need to make sure they go through specialized training so that they can remove the most poisonous parts of that fish to make sure that you are not ingesting that toxin. Now, venom is going to be something that means that it bites you or it got injected into your bloodstream. And the most venomous fish is actually going to be the stonefish. Stonefish have spines that run around their bodies, and if you step on them or something tried to bite down on those spines, then those spines will release that venom. And there are actually five different species of stonefish, and they're all found in the Indian and Pacific Oceans. We have stonefish off of our coastlines here. So remember, venom and poison are two different things. Alright, so now we're getting to our last question of the day. What body part or adaptation allows fish to school in large numbers? What body part or adaptation allows fish to be able to school? None of these fish behind me are actually schooling fish, so you won't be able to see that meat if you're in this. But what allows fish to be able to school? It's really cool to get a chance to see. Fish have what's known as a lateral line running down the length of their body, which is a series of gel-filled pores with a cilia, or a hair, sticking out of them. And it goes from the head to their tail, running down the sides of the body. Now these fish are in the position here. Okay, from head to tail, there we go, just like that. And that lateral line is what they use to sense movements or pressure changes in the water. So when fish are in a school, they don't talk to each other and say, hey, we're going to turn 1, 2, 3. One of them just does it and the rest of the fish follow. Now, fish that are in the center of the school are actually going to be the ones that are going to control the directions of the movements of the turn. And they will sense that motion to avoid any predators, or even help successfully hunt their prey. So schooling has multiple benefits for these fish, so that way they can move around safely across the ocean. So what happens is one of them in the center feels a water change, and so they turn left or right, or up or down, wherever they're going, and the other fish follow through. And that's it for our trivia on fish today. I hope you had a great time. How'd you do? Did you do a good job? Be sure to join us next time as we post all kinds of different videos learning about nature and all the wonderful things in it. Hope you've had a great time playing trivia today, and we'll see you next time on Learning Coast here with you.